Court, this is Virginia.
Yes, may I speak with Mr. McNally, please?
And who should I tell him is calling, please?
You can call me Star.
Star?
Yes.
Okay, one moment, please.
Yes, Mr. McNally, this is Star for the family Hills.
Uh-huh.
I'm calling you in regards to the two written responses that you sent to my administrative complaint, which was served on you May 26th, and also my 24-hour notice that to amend or cure your administrative procedure. And in your written responses dated June 1st, you stated, quote, Mr. Allen David is not a party to the case. As such, I am ethically unable to respond to the most recent demands given my responsibility to the parties of the case. First of all, Mr. Allen David is a fictitious name that doesn't exist, and also so is Miss Star Hills. He is not the one who made the complaint. I am. And you did not respond to my complaint or my notice. You erroneously sent a letter misaddressed to me, addressed incorrectly. And if you had taken note of my notice of status and the Title 18 violations that I filed in the case, which I asked you to take notice of in these complaints, you would understand that I am not these fictitious names. Or fictitious addresses. Have you actually read these documents, the complaint or the notices that I've sent to you?
In fact, I've had more than myself. I've read them. I've had an attorney in my office read them, and I've had staff read them. And I was not able to discuss the matter with that individual that continued to show up at court suggesting that he represented you. Not authorized to represent you, so...
He did not show up contending to represent me in any way, shape, or form. He merely delivered, signed the proof of services.
The first thing he said to me is that he didn't have the power of attorney.
That does not mean that he's representing me. Yes, he does have a power of attorney. Well, I'm going to give you another offer, a final opportunity to respond to the merits of my administrative complaint, which you have failed to do. You have done nothing more than throw the matter off and not address any of the merits of this complaint.
Mm-hmm. How would you like me to do that?
It's all in the paperwork, Mr. McNally.
Right. So since I sent it to the wrong name and address, would you like me to get the name and address so I can respond in writing to your concerns?
Yes, it's all in the paperwork. What I am called, the correct mailing location to send anything to me. And I suggest that you take note of that. And if anything is sent to me, to any mailing location, because I would hate for anyone to try to engage me in a mail fraud and have to go before the UPU, you might not be so negligent as to address things incorrectly to a fictitious entity and title things fictitiously, or send them to fraudulent addresses, which I do not consent to. How long have you been in office, Mr. McNally?
I've been here 15 years.
I see that you hold three public offices. Is this true?
I hold one office. I have a number of titles.
You have one office, but a number of titles. And what are these titles?
I am the court executive officer. I am the clerk of the Superior Court, and I am the jury commissioner.
Did you swear an oath for all of these titles?
I did, yes, ma'am.
And do you receive a separate paycheck for each title?
No, ma'am, I do not.
And are you bonded?
Am I bonded?
Yes.
Yes, as a clerk of the court, I'm bonded, yes.
And who is your bonding agency?
Superiot Court.
And where can I find your oath and your bond on file?
It's in my personnel file. You can apply for that by sending a letter to the presiding.
Okay, well, I think that that will probably clear up any of these matters. You failed to do your duty here and to issue a order to show cause. And no one anywhere in these documents, I have not ever contended that it is your job to sanction anyone, but it is your job to enter an order to show cause. And you have failed to address that issue. According to your local rule, 3.17.16.
Well, it's nice talking to you. I'll follow that up with you, and I'll be sending you something in writing.
Okay, thank you, and I'll be seeking your bond and your oath. Thank you.